Okay, so now we have done a couple of things with our precious samples. The first thing we did was running the PCR2 program. After the PCR2 program, we did run a gel to see if the negative controls are still blank, that we have samples in the samples that we should have DNA in it. And we have also checked that the positive control works, checked for the amount of dimers we have in our samples. So this is all done with the same procedure for the gel as you have already watched. It's exactly the same, no difference. After that, we did another bead cleaning to purify the DNA. And this was done exactly the same way as previously. So nothing new there. And we now have the samples. They are now purified. They have been running through the gel. And now we are ready for the quantification. And the quantification is one of the last key steps we need to perform, because this is where we find out the quality of DNA and the amount of DNA as well. And here you have a little bit of different options to how you do the quantification. We use two main protocols, and they are smart for two different sample sizes. That's kind of the main thing. If you have below, I would say, 40 samples, then you should use the qubit protocol. The qubits is very accurate, it's quite fast, it's very simple, it's an easy protocol to do, but what it's more time consuming if you get more samples than 40. And if you have more than 40 samples, then I strongly recommend the picogreen setup. And here I will explain the picogreen more in detail, because that's the one that is a little bit more complicated, even though the protocol is quite okay to understand when you look it up in the Dropbox. But how it works is that we use different reagents to bind fluorescence particles to the DNA, and then we measure the amount of light when it has been irradiated with light in a special machine. So here it's very important to follow the procedure. And in the procedure, you have three different ways of doing it. The first way is the high sensitivity, and you have a medium sensitivity, and you have a low sensitivity. These are specialized for different amounts of DNA in your sample. For example, you can use the high sensitivity to quantify samples that have low amounts of DNA, and then the medium range, which is the one I think fits most of the samples we are working with right now. So I would recommend using that. And then we have the low sensitivity that are for example, sediment samples and like samples that are very dense with genetic material. And some key things here is that since we are working with fluorescence, light is our enemy, right? Because sunlight or light from light bulbs or indoor lighting as well is problematic. So to do these steps in the procedure, you need to turn off the light in the room you're working with. Of course, it doesn't need to be as dark so you don't see where you're working, but you still need to turn off the light. So, okay, so that's kind of the quantification, and read up on it in the Dropbox and see how you do it. And yeah, see what kind of plates and material you need. But the reason why it's so important to quantify the amount of DNA is that to send it to sequencing, we need to do something that is called pooling. That means that we take all the different samples here and fit it into one Eppendorf tubes. And this is possible since we have given it different barcodes in PCR2. So we can mix them and trace them back, but they need to be in the same equimolar amount. This translated that we need to have the same amount of DNA from each sample. So say that we want to take out 40 nanograms of DNA from sample 1, sample 2, sample 3, and sample 4 from each of them. These samples will have different concentrations. So I need to take, to get 40 nanograms from this tube, I need to take out a given volume. The same for this, and the same for this, and the same for this, to mix it in these equimolar concentrations. And that is why the quantification is so important, because here we get the answer to how much, how big is the concentration in each of these tubes that we need to do the calculations for the equimolar concentration in the final pool that we send into sequencing.